A new report's found that the cost of rent's become so out of control that nearly half of the renters in this country can no longer afford to make their payments. And make things worse, virtually nothing is being done to solve the problem. We're talking about rents that have gone up 2 and 3 times just in the last 24 months. And so somebody who's day one, they're paying $700, all of a sudden is paying $1,600, $1,700, along with having to make, you know, they've got utility issues, they've got inflation issues. They've got wrenching decisions that they have to make. Do I pay my rent? Do I pay my bills? Do I run the risk of being evicted? Can I pay just half rent? You don't realize this until you're in the middle of it, but you hear these stories, and right now, I don't see any way it's turning around. No, I don't see anything in the horizon that's going to turn this around.
No, there is not a single piece of legislation being proposed, not a single piece of legislation pending. There's not even really discussion of this from our leaders in Washington, D.C. on either side of the aisle. This has been a problem that we have talked about before. It's been a problem that even the most corporate of news outlets have talked about. And nobody is doing a thing about this. These people are telling in this new report, saying, listen, after I pay my rent for this apartment or this, you know, rental house I've been in for 5 years, I pay my rent. I have less than $300 for the rest of the month to buy food for my children, to buy gas for my car. I cannot sustain this for more than a few more months before I'm out in the street. And here's what gets me too. This report says the housing market's telling us, well, it's because there's a shortage. There is not a home shortage in the United States. We have more.
That's coming from the White House. They're trying to defend themselves. It's not our fault.
Yeah.
It's not our fault. There's a housing shortage. That's complete
bullshit. We have more vacant homes than we have unhoused people in this country.
Yeah.
We could give every one of them a free house and we wouldn't even notice.
So you've got a homeless rate that hits its historical high. Saw an article coming out of San Francisco where a family of four, think about this, a family of four needs more than $200,000 a year just to live, have a place to live, and pay their bills. $200,000. So it's not just, first of all, it's not a housing shortage.
Right.
What is happening, though, this part of the story is Wall Street's coming in and buying up big swaths of entire neighborhoods. And those used to be, you know, single family type homes that a young couple could buy. Now the prices are just so outrageous because corporate America is involved and there's no controls over it. You know, there are things from the executive level that can be done to stop this, but nothing's being done. Now, when Wall Street gets involved, the media has already dropped the ball. You can't even find these articles in the media. No. When Wall Street's involved and they own everything, these stories are going to disappear because Wall Street's going to be paying advertising on MSNBC and CNN and ABC. They're going to control the networks just like they do with everything else by advertising dollars.
Yeah, and not to mention, I mean, a lot of these Wall Street executives also sit on the boards of directors for the media companies.
Yes.
So they literally get to control what's happening at these places. And again, the part that drives me crazy is that there's nothing at all being done about this. And this, we see these stories about, oh, look at the economy. It's doing great. We added more jobs than ever. The stock market's doing better than ever. Listen, get down to the nitty gritty of it, and you're going to see how bad people are doing in this country.
There's something called rent control. Okay, people know that term.
Yeah.
And right now you have a White House who's not trying to get at least Democratic governors to say, you have the right to do this. But nothing's being done because, you know what, it's just because the media, it's a sleeper story. They won't do their job as usual.